Hey guys, in today's video, I have a classic battle between ATI and Nvidia with two cards from 2006. We have the ATI 1900 XT and the Nvidia 7900 GS. And it's kind of funny if you're a fan of pixel pipes. He just released a similar video with two cards from a slightly earlier time period covering mostly the same games, but shout out to his channel as he seems to be back from a long break. And if you're a fan of these card battle videos, he's the master. I've been wanting to do this video for a while now. I built a mid-2000s retro PC a few months ago, and I started with the ATI card, but I wanted to get an Nvidia card to see if I would get a performance boost in Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. However, these two cards do make an interesting matchup. So on paper, the 1900 XT is a much stronger card, but consider that the 7900 GS is smaller, takes a single slot, less power, and it's almost silent. Also, it was much cheaper than the 1900 XT, being about half its price. Keep in mind, this is the 512 meg version of the 1900 XT, hence the hefty price tag. I did overclock the 7900 somewhat. It is a famous card to overclock, and I was only able to up the GPU clock to 532 from 450. So without any further delay, let's get to the test results. 3D mark test to start, and not surprisingly, the score spread widens as we go up through the years from the 01 to 05 versions. Very little difference in the 01 version, but large differences seen in the 03 and 05 tests. Call of Duty 1, I must have had VSync on here as I'm capped at 60 FPS, but everything on high settings, highest resolution, you're going to be locked at 60 on both of these cards for pretty much the whole game. Halo and the 7900 does well here. With VSync off, we can really see the 1900 XT start to take off. Still, you're going to have great performance with either card. Now, Half-Life 2, huge difference here. The 7900 GS was choking on these settings. Now, obviously, I have to compare apples to apples here, but I'm confident if you use all the recommended settings, tuning the anti-aliasing down, you could have a great experience on the 7900 GS. But the 1900 XT really blew the competition out of the water. And just to clarify, by choking, I just mean that the min FPS score goes really low, in spite of the fact that the average FPS is above 60. So after seeing the results of the chart in Half-Life 2, you might expect to see similar results in Doom 3, but this was the big surprise of the whole test. These two cards were like neck and neck in Doom 3. Apparently Doom 3 favors Nvidia, so that's probably the explanation. Maybe there's some updated drivers or something for ATI I could use to really get the full performance, but not sure what's going on here. But still a pretty good gaming experience on both cards with this setting. Oblivion, high settings, 1024 by 768. The 1900 XT was a much, much smoother experience. If you're going to play this game on a retro PC, make sure to have something as powerful or more as the 1900 XT to really be able to pump up those graphic settings and resolution. System specs will be in the video description, by the way, if you're wondering what system I was running on. With fear, probably what you would expect to see. Maybe surprising seeing the 7900 GS hold up so well, especially with everything maxed out. Same thing in Crysis, although on low settings, of course. There's no huge advantage over using the ATI card here. And finally, just a summary of all the games showing the average FPS. Again, no big surprise here. And to sum things up, if you're looking to have a better experience in, say, Oblivion, definitely look to upgrade to the 1900 XT. I think the 7900 GS is a solid choice, though, if your build is going to target that 2003 to 2005 era and you want something quiet, efficient, and powerful. So that's it for today. Just a short video. I'm happy to finish it. Hope to see you next time and take care.